Ever wonder what it really means to be a hacker? I mean, not the hack Instagram in 5 minutes clickbait nonsense. I'm talking about the real, gritty, behind-the-scenes truth. Today, I'm revealing the unfiltered reality of hacking. The stuff no one tells you. The part that never makes it into those flashy YouTube videos. So grab your coffee. This one's gonna sting a little. Becoming a hacker isn't something that happens overnight. It takes years of grinding, studying code, understanding how systems really work, and most importantly, learning to think differently. You're up late, not to binge Netflix, but debugging some broken Python script or reverse engineering a tool just to see how it ticks. You're not out partying. You're sitting with Kali Linux open, packet sniffing your own network just to learn how to secure it. And after all that, someone DMs you like, "Bro, can you hack my ex's Facebook? I'll give you 500 rupees." Excuse me, what? That's like asking a surgeon to pop a pimple for $5. Bro, no. Most people think hacking is some magical shortcut, like there's a secret app that opens any Instagram account. Spoiler alert, there isn't. Those viral videos shouting "hack Snapchat in 2 minutes," they're garbage. They usually show fake tools with some sketchy interface where you just type the username and boom, access granted. That's not hacking, that's acting. They don't teach you anything. They just make you a script kiddie, someone who runs tools without knowing how or why they work. Worse, some of these tools are actual malware. While you think you're hacking someone, joke's on you. You're the one getting hacked. Let's talk about the movies. Oh boy, they've done a fantastic job of turning hackers into hooded keyboard ninjas who type 400 words per minute while green code rains down the screen like the Matrix. Reality? Half the time you're sitting in silence, waiting for a port scan to finish, staring at your screen for hours, hoping something breaks. And when it doesn't, you go back and try again. There's no dramatic music. No access granted pop-up, just terminal windows, logs, and coffee. Sometimes hacking is literally just patience. Real hackers, especially ethical ones, work for companies, not against them. They're penetration testers, security analysts, red teamers. They find vulnerabilities with permission to help secure systems before the bad guys get in. So next time someone says, "Bro, can you hack my school system and change my grades?" We're not laughing because it's impossible. We're laughing because it's dumb. That's not what this skill was built for. It's like buying a Ferrari and using it to deliver groceries. Another funny one, the gear obsession. People think you need 3 monitors, RGB lights, and a quantum processor to be a hacker. Nope. I know guys who can break into networks using a 10-year-old laptop and a Wi-Fi adapter that costs less than a burger. Because it's not about the machine. It's about the mind behind the machine. Tools are just that. Tools. Without the knowledge, they're useless. So yeah, if a hacker sounds annoyed when you ask them to hack someone's WhatsApp, now you know why. We didn't spend years learning buffer overflows and encryption just to stalk your cheating boyfriend. We built this skill out of passion, curiosity, and a desire to understand the digital world. But the world around us? They still think hacking is either criminal or cool-looking movie stuff. Rarely the truth. That misunderstanding is what drives real hackers nuts. Here's the truth. Hacking is not a shortcut. Hacking is not about breaking rules. Hacking is a skill, and one that can be used to build, protect, and even change the world. So the next time someone says, "Can you hack my crush's account?" just tell them, "Bro, go talk to her instead." And if you really want to learn hacking, not the fake kind, but the real, ethical, practical stuff, you're in the right place. Like, share. And subscribe because we drop real content that teaches real skills. No gimmicks, no shortcuts, just truth. I'll see you in the next video. Stay sharp, stay ethical.